How's going guys, welcome to the channel. In this video we are gonna see, what if Naruto got harem with Twilight, Celestia and Luna. Part 2. If you wants to see awesome fanfiction like this, don't forget to subscribe. Now let's get into the video. Before anyone could do anything, a tune came from D-Nasty's pocket getting his attention. Hold on. D-Nasty said, pulling out a blue smartphone. What's that? Spike asked. The smartphone. D-Nasty said, seeing the confused faces he waved his hand. Don't worry about it. It's something from my world. Basically it's a mobile device that lets you talk and message people. That sounds like something that can be useful in Equestria. Rarity muttered. Hello? D-Nasty asked, talking to somebody. Oh really? Are you sure? I mean I don't want to question you, but we'll yeah true since they are a part of his life. He said, scratching his head. If you say so. I'll bring them in. D-Nasty hung up his smartphone. Who was that? Fluttershy asked. That was the person who made up the story asking me to pull in a few extra ponies from your world to read the story. D-Nasty said, putting the phone away. Who? Applejack wondered. You'll see. Wait here while I go get them. D-Nasty reached behind him with his right hand and pulled out a red gem. Ooh, what a beautiful gem. Rarity gushed. Yep. And it has a lot of power in it. D-Nasty grinned, raising his hand in the air as the gem glowed. Always wanted to do this. Chaos control. D-Nasty disappeared in a flash of red light, surprising everyone. That was awesome. Apple, Bloom shouted. Yeah. No doubt. Rainbow Dash grinned. Seems like to me he teleported. Loon said. The flash of red and D-Nasty came back with Derpy Hooves, Dinky Doo, Vinyl Scratch, Octavia, and Trixie around him. I'm back with the ponies to read the story. D-Nasty grinned, putting the gem away. Derpy, Dinky. Rainbow Dash grinned, waving for them to sit near her, Twilight, Spike, Applejack, and Pinkie Pie, having enough room for them. Hi Rainbow Dash. Derpy smiled as she sat beside Rainbow Dash. How you been, Dinky? Scootaloo asked. I've been fine. Though I've been wondering what this mysterious man meant when he told Mom, me and the others that we'll be reading a story. Dinky sitting beside her mother. You guys will love it. Rarity said. Yeah. So far it's really good. Pinkie Pie grinned. What's the story about? Trixie asked, sitting on the couch with the Cutie Mark Crusaders. It's about an awesome person named Naruto from a different dimension who comes into our world turning into a unicorn. Apple, Bloom said. What's he look like? Octavia wondered as she and Vinley sat on a couch beside Rarity and Fluttershy. You'll see. Twilight smiled. Though fair warning. He is quite the looker. Rainbow Dash grinned cheekily. Is he that handsome? Vinyl said. Though is he. Luna giggled. Here I'll get you guys up to speed. D-Nasty said, sitting back down in his rocking chair and pulling out a remote, flipping the channel to the first chapter. You guys don't mind watching it again, do you? I'm fine with it since it'll get the other to catch up with us. Celestia said. Yeah. Not to mention we get to see where Naruto fights again. Scootaloo grins. That's right. Start away, D-Nasty. Pinkie Pie cheered. I still can't believe that's his name. Vinyl snickered. I will get a paddle and spank you. D-Nasty threatened. Meep. Vinyl squeaked in fear, clenching her bottom. I always told you to watch what you say. Octavia sighed. Anyway, let's get you guys caught up. D-Nasty said, pressing play. D-Nasty showed Derpy, Dinky, Vinyl, Octavia, and Trix chapter 1 through 6, and each one they felt themselves get wrapped up in the story. When they finished, D-Nasty put away his remote and looked at them. Pretty cool, huh? D-Nasty grinned. That was so cool. Dinky gushed. That Naruto is quite the amazing stallion. Octavia smiled. Amazing. Tri-spectacular, Tavi. This guy's okay in my book. Vinyl laughed. Trixie can agree on that. Trixie agreed. He seems like a nice person willing to help others like that. Derpy grinned. Well, I'm glad you like it, cause you all will learn about Naruto's past. D-Nasty said. If I could, I want to read next. Fluttershy said. Go ahead. D-Nasty smiled, making Fluttershy beam as Applejack tossed her the book. Okay. Fluttershy breathed, easing herself before reading. Chapter 6. Visiting the memories of a past life. Upon returning to Ponyville, many ponies of the town cheered at the return of Princess Celestia, as well as the revival of Princess Luna, as they rode in the golden chariot, followed by Naruto and the other mares. Naruto was feeling a bit uncomfortable since he had never received praise from a large number of people. Everyone laughed or giggled, seeing Naruto all nervous, while the mares thought it made him look cute looking away from them. Naruto noticed the Twilight Sparkle had a sad look on her face as they walked to the town hall. Twilight, why are you feeling so down? Said Naruto, drawing the attention of the others. It's just that after finally making friends with you and the others, I would have to go back to Canterlot, Twilight said sadly. Hearing that, Naruto became depressed as well since he enjoys having her around despite the short time they spent together. Looking at Applejack and the other mares, they were also feeling sad at the thought of being separated. See Twilight, Naruto likes you. Spike grinned at her. It's nice to know that, Spike. Twilight smiled at him rubbing his head. Hearing what Twilight said, Celestia told Spike to take up a pen and paper to write, I Princess Celestia, hereby decree that my student Twilight Sparkle, is to remain in Ponyville to learn about friendship with the element bearers, as well as study on the new element of harmony, and send reports about her research, said Celestia smiling gently as Twilight hugged her in happiness. Naruto and the mares were happy at not having to be separated. Pinkie Pie was about to dash off before Naruto used his tail to grab her. Now hold on there, party planner. Remember I said that I would tell you my story after the battle with Nightmare Moon, said Naruto, bringing their attention to him. But before we leave, I will need Apple Bloom, Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo to come along. They should also hear of this as I don't like keeping secrets from those I care about. As soon as the fillies arrived, Princess Celestia used her magic to teleport them to the royal castle. The mares, especially Rarity, were excited to be there but calmed down, since they wanted to learn more about their friend. After being led to the throne room, everyone turned to Naruto to begin his story. So tell us about your life before coming to Ponyville, said Celestia, with Luna standing next to her wanting to learn about the stallion who saved her. Everyone but D-Nasty leaned forward ready to learn about Naruto. Geez, I don't know where to begin, Naruto was saying when his glaive appeared in a flash of light. Kase no ha, but I didn't call you out. The glaive glowed brightly, forcing every pony to close their eyes. When they opened them, they were standing in a forest with a large tree at the center of it. Where are we? Asked Rainbow Dash, looking around. This is my mindscape. Kase no ha thought it would be better that I show you my memories of my past life, so it drew all of you in, said Naruto, who stood at the bottom of the large tree. Didn't his mindscape look like a sewer? Vinyl asked. It must have changed. Luna said. You mean you had a past life before you came to Equestria? Said Rarity with a look of surprise. Yes, back then, I used to be a human in my world like this, said Naruto, transforming into his human form, surprising the others. I read about creatures called humans in the books. There used to be some in Equestria, but they all disappeared without a trace, said Twilight. It would seem that they disappeared to other worlds. I was there when it happened, said Princess Celestia, with Luna agreeing. Did that happen here too? Applejack asked. It probably did, a long, long time ago to where I can't remember, Celestia said. I wouldn't be surprised if it did. D-Nasty said. Well, in my world I used to live in a land called the Elemental Nations, and there are villages called the Five Shinobi Villages where ninjas live, said Naruto. You mean those warriors who fight in the shadows, use smoke to hide, and all those cool stuff, said Pinkie Pie, bouncing around excitedly, much to Naruto's amusement. Pinkie asked the same thing. Fluttershy giggled as Pinkie bopped her head, sticking out her tongue. Yes, and I used to be one. I lived in the Hidden Leaf Village, which is one of the Five Shinobi Villages, said Naruto, as a large mirror appeared and displayed an image of a village. As the ponies looked closer, they saw the stone faces on the mountain was painted with, and that a younger Naruto was running away from two older humans, whilst carrying a can of paint, to which they all laughed. Everyone else laughed when they saw that. What the? Derpy giggled. What was that? Applejack laughed. It will be explained. D-Nasty chuckled. Naruto, what was that all about? Asked Rainbow Dash while laughing, with the others wondering the same thing. When I was still at the village before I became a ninja, I used to play pranks on the village to get attention, and even the high-ranked ninjas could never catch me, said Naruto with a smirk. But why strive for attention? I'm sure your parents were there to support, said Applejack. Hearing that, a look of sadness appeared on his face, which gave the mares a bad feeling. Everyone else felt sad, remembering how Naruto lost his parents after he was just born. Well, to tell you the truth, a demon fox had attacked the village, and my father, who was the village leader along with my mother, sacrificed their lives to seal it away in a newborn baby, which was me, and died believing that I would be treated as a hero, but the villagers believed that I was the reincarnation of the fox, and mistreated me since then, said Naruto. Upon hearing that, the mares were shocked. Fluttershy, Pinkie Pie and the fillies began to cry, wondering why something like that should happen to a pony like him. So that's why you always support me, because you know the feeling of loneliness, thought Scootaloo. Scootaloo smiled, feeling Naruto understood her. It's a surprise that you didn't fall to darkness like any pony would have, how come? Said Celestia, to which Naruto smiled gently. It's because I met people who saw me for who I am, and not for what I contain. They also taught me that when I want to protect those precious to me, that's when you gain true strength, said Naruto, while looking the mares, especially Luna, who nodded in understanding. Everyone smiled at how Naruto felt about gaining strength to protect those important to you, and they all felt the same, having someone they would protect. Afterward, Naruto showed them his memories from his first mission, the invasion which frightened Fluttershy a bit when they watched him against a boy who was also a container like Naruto, the battle against Orochimaru until they reached his last memory. What happened here, Naruto? Asked Rarity, who was pointing at the image of Naruto facing off against his teammate. Back at the ninja exam, Sasuke had received a curse seal from that snake which gave him power, but corrupted him as well, and with his desire to avenge his clan, it made him leave the village to join Orochimaru in order to gain more power, said Naruto. I believe Sasuke was in the wrong there. Octavia frowned. I agree. Power isn't everything. Luna said. Tell it, sister. Trixie agreed. I believe you went after him in order to bring him back to the village, since he is your friend, as well as your teammate, said Twilight. Naruto nodded in response. I was assigned to a squad to bring him back, and we split up to face each of Orochimaru's elites, till I was the last one to catch up with Sasuke. I tried to reason with him, but he wouldn't listen, so we fought, said Naruto, as the memory of the battle was displayed. The battle escalated when he used the power of the cursed seal, forcing me to use the power of the nine-tailed fox to fight back, and in the end, we clashed with our best techniques with him killing me, but I knocked him out. Then how did you come to Equestria? Asked Luna, trying to hold back tears along with the mares who were sad at how things turned out for the blonde stallion. When I died, I met Kami-sama, who is the god of my world. She asked me what I wanted to do with the soul of the nine-tailed fox, which I requested to be sent back to its own world, as I found out that the fox was under someone's control when he attacked the village. That's also when Kasei Noha appeared and chose me to be its wielder, and the fox unlocked my power as a sign of apology before I was reborn in Equestria, said Naruto. I felt what Naruto did for Kurama was nice. Dinky smiled. I agree, sweetie. It shows even the meanest people can change if you give them a chance. Derpy smiled at her daughter. But Naruto, don't you miss them back in your world? Asked Fluttershy worriedly. It's true that I miss them, however I have you all who are precious to me, and I will be with you forever, and that's a promise, said Naruto with a foxy grin, making the fillies run up to Naruto and hug him. The mares were also happy to hear that he cares about them very much. Seems Naruto would rather stay with us than his world. Rarity smiled, as did everyone else. Is the power the fox gave you the one you used back at the Evertree Forest? Asked Twilight. Yes, it enables me to use my chakra to form anything as well as enhance my physical abilities. Also, I can use magic, but I need to learn how. I'm sure you could teach me, said Naruto, to which she nodded. My Kasei Noha is a special glaive that can transform into anything I wish during battle, and I am still training to master its power. Soon the glaive glowed brightly again, and they were back in the throne room and returned itself back to Naruto. So what would you do now, Naruto? Will you travel throughout the land? Asked Applejack with a hint of sadness that is mirrored by the other mares and fillies. Naruto shook his head in negative. No, I am rather happier staying in Ponyville with you all, as you are all precious to me. Besides, I promised to spend a day with each of you, said Naruto with a foxy grin, making the mares blush at the thought of spending time alone with the stallion. Looks like certain ponies are going to be glad to spend a day alone with Naruto. Trixie teased, making the main six blush. After giving Princess Celestia the elements of harmony, Naruto and the mares were transported back to Ponyville, not before he promised to visit every once in a while. That was pretty short. Dinky pouted. Yeah. I mean, we have a understanding of his past, but not much. Rainbow Dash frowned. Don't worry. Cause now I'll show you guys Naruto's past myself. D-Nasty grinned, taking a remote and turned the channel to where Naruto being in an orphanage. So sit back, relax, and we'll see his entire backstory to his and Sasuke's fight. Ooh, I can't wait. Scootaloo shook in excitement. Well then, let's begin. D-Nasty said, clicking play. The screen turned blank, ending the scene from where Naruto and Sasuke clashed their Judas. And that was Naruto's life that led up to that point in time. D-Nasty said. Man, talk about living hard. Rainbow Dash muttered. Even Trixie thinks some of the things in that world are unfair. Trixie frowned. Even though I feel sorry for Sasuke, I'm still mad he was willing to throw away his friendship with people and kill Naruto for power. Pinkie Pie huffed. You said it, my dear. That brute doesn't deserve Naruto's friendship. Rarity nodded in agreement. That Orochimaru guy scares me. Dinky shuddered. I know, sweetie. Derpy agreed, comforting her daughter. I admire Naruto's resolve. Even when things were done, he still pushed through and tried to look at the best of things. Fluttershy said. Dear darn tootin', Fluttershy. Applejack nodded. Anyway, since you've seen Naruto's life, I hope you got a better understanding of who he is. D-Nasty said. I believe we all have. Celestia smiled. That's right. Luna smiled. He really is a remarkable person. Twilight said. HMM. Spike, Sweetie Belle, Apple Bloom, and Scootaloo agreed. Well then, who wants to read the next chapter? D-Nasty asked. I will. Rarity raised her hoof. Alright. D-Nasty said, handing her the book and began to read. Chapter 7. Days with the Mares, Rarity said.
What's that about?
Rainbow Dash asked, confused.
Oh.
I bet it's about the promise Naruto made to us when he was going to take on Nightmare Moon. Pinkie Pie said, bouncing up and down.
I think you might be right, Pinkie Pie.
Twilight agreed.
I wonder how they'll play out.
Vinyl wondered.
We'll find out.
Octavia said.
It had been a couple of days since the battle against Nightmare Moon, things had settled down at Ponyville. Since Twilight, Sparkle and Spike now live in the library, Naruto took a temporal residence at the Apple family's home, much to Applejack's joy and the envy of the other mares. Twilight, Pinkie Pie, Rainbow Dash, Rarity, Fluttershy, Celestia, and Luna frowned at Applejack, who smirked and stuck her tongue out, making them frown more as Derpy, Dinky, Spike, Scootaloo, Sweetie Belle, Vinyl, Octavia, Trixie, and D-Nasty snickered. Naruto is currently on his bed thinking deeply about what he plans on how he will spend the days with one of the mares. Pinkie Pie gave a whoop at being right, making everyone chuckle. I wonder what I should do. Hum, thought Naruto, then he looked at the crystals and scrolls that lay on top of the table. Whenever he got time, Naruto would practice on his fuinjutsu and study the crystals that had piqued his curiosity. Normally the crystal would be transparent, but when he channels his chakra magic into them, they change colors and then revert back to normal. As for his fuinjutsu, he would normally use his chakra arms to draw, but lately started using his tail as it is more accurate and clear. He came on a dead end when he realized that only he could properly use the seals, but theorized that magic could serve as a substitute, but needs a medium which he found in the crystals. Maybe using fuinjutsu on the crystals would give them a special effect like storage, heating and much more, he thought, but decided to think about it later, since he has to spend time with one of the main six tomorrow.
Next day.
With Pinkie Pie.
Yes.
I'm first. Pinkie Pie cheered, making the other mares of the main six grumble. The next day, Naruto headed to the town square to meet up with Pinkie Pie to spend time together. When he got there, she was nowhere to be seen. For Pinkie not to be here must mean that she is going to surprise me from out of nowhere, since I always fail to detect her, despite being a ninja. Naruto signed in resignation. Sure enough, he was tackled to the ground by a pink blur, which revealed to be the excitable mare.
Pinaru. I'm so happy to see you. So what are we going to do today?
Plan a party. Run all over the place.
Ha, ha, ha. Said Pinkie Pie, bouncing around.
Actually, Pinks, I was planning that we have fun cooking something for each over. After all, you always treat me to the snacks at the sugar cube corner, so I want to do the same for you, and I want you to try out the food from my world, although it will be a bit different from the original, said Naruto, while using his tail to lift Pinkie from him, in order to get up from the ground.
Okay, Naru. Let's go to the sugar cube corner since it's closed for the day. I'm sure whatever you cook will taste great, and I'm also going to bake a cake so that we can eat together, so let's go. Said Pinkie Pie before grabbing Naruto and dragging him to the sweet shop, much to the amusement of the ponies around. Everyone chuckled at Pinkie's excitement while said pony laughed. When they got to the shop, Pinkie immediately began on preparing the cake, while Naruto watched from a distance.
Whoa, Pinkie really knows how to work her way around the place. That bears testament to how skilled she is at baking, thought Naruto as he looked on for a while, but then got up and approached Pinkie.
Hey Pinks, mind if I lend a hoof?
I'm sure that it will be quicker and more fun that way, said Naruto and was then hugged by Pinkie.
You're right, Naru, it will definitely be more fun that way, so let's get started. Said Pinkie Pie.
Soon, they went on at the preparations. It was going smoothly, but chaos reared its head when Naruto playfully flicked a bit of batter from the spoon at Pinkie, which landed on her face. Retaliating, she flicked a bit of batter back at him. Soon the exchange turned into all-out war, resulting in a messy kitchen and the duo laughing at each other. Feeling curious at how the batter tasted, Naruto licked it off Pinkie's face, which left her blushing, making him blush as well.
Pinkie blushed at that while the others oohed.
By my, how daring.
Vinyl teased.
Quite.
Octavia grinned.
You know, I didn't think Pinkie could blush.
Derpy giggled.
I don't think anyone did.
Spike laughed.
You guys are mean.
Pinkie pouted, still blushing, making everyone chuckle.
Sorry about that, my curiosity got the better of me, said Naruto while rubbing the back of his head.
It's okay, Naru, I would have done the same just for fun, said Pinkie, smiling although her heart was beating very fast.
After cleaning the kitchen, the duo continued until they put it into the oven.
Now that it's in the oven, watch me cook the greatest dish gifted to humans by the gods, Raymond. Said Naruto with pride while Pinkie watched from a distance.
Thanks to helping Tucci and A.M. in cooking the ramen at Ichiraku, he was well knowledge in cooking the dish, and soon the soup was bubbling on the stove and is about to work on the dough. Now watch a master at work.
Naruto called out to Pinkie Pie, who looked on in excitement.
Everyone but D-Nasty was curious on how Naruto would make ramen now that he was a pony.
Naruto formed a Rasengan with a chakra arm which amazed Pinky, and slammed it onto the mixture which began to spin and stir, until the technique faded away. With the spinning of the Rasengan, the ingredients would be evened out and make the noodles more tasty, said Naruto. Then he formed another chakra arm and proceeded to pound it until it was tough. With that, the dough is now firm enough to be made into strings without brikage, said Naruto. Then he began to twist and stretch until it's in strings before using the Chikurahansarasu to cut them. The audience was amazed at Naruto's cooking skills.
That was quite amazing. Rarity said impressed.
You got that right, sis.
Sweetie Belle nodded.
Ain't nothing more attracting than a man that can cook, I tell you what.
Applejack grinned.
That's so cool with what you did, Neru, I've never seen anything like it. Said Pinkie Pie, who was amazed by the display.
Thanks, Pinks, now all we have to do is boil the noodles in hot water, and then we are all set, said Naruto smiling. After the ramen was ready and the cake had cooled down, they carried them to the table.
You may have the first taste, Pinks, I'm sure it will be unforgettable, said Naruto with anticipation.
Pinky took a bite of the ramen and have a shocked look on her face which worried Naruto until he saw sparkles in eyes.
Wow. This has to be the tastiest I had aside from muffins, the others have to try it. Said Pinky, who was barely able to contain herself.
The nasty saw the intrigued look from everyone.
If you want, I can bring in the ramen Naruto made for you all to try. He offered.
We would like that. Celestia smiled.
The nasty snapped his fingers, and a bowl of ramen for each person appeared in their laps, with the steam from it hitting their noses, making them hungry.
When everyone took a bite of the ramen, their eyes widened before they ate more with gusto, and before you know it, they finished it as they all sighed in content.
Now that was tasty. Rainbow Dash laughed.
It was the most amazing thing I ever ate. Scootaloo said.
No doubt.
Apple, Bloom said.
Will we be able to have more if we could?
Twilight asked.
Sure.
D-Nasty shrugged.
Sure, but for now it's just you and me, so let's have some of the cake that you made, said Naruto. After eating the cake and ramen, he bade farewell to the excitable mare and went back to rest for the next day.
Next day. With Rainbow Dash.
I guess I'm next.
Rainbow Dash grinned.
Naruto was heading towards the highest hill in the town, where he and Rainbow Dash often meet up to chat and have fun. As he was trotting to the meeting place, Naruto sensed a slight disturbance in the air and spun to the side, and he used his tail to stretch out to catch a blue blur, before it introduced itself to the ground.
You really need to work on your landings, after all you are the best flyer around, said Naruto with a smirk at the Pegasus, who was blushing in embarrassment.
Rainbow Dash chuckled sheepishly as everyone else snickered.
Sorry about that, Naruto, I was trying to surprise you before you get to our usual spot, said Rainbow Dash with a grin.
You know, if you were a Pegasus, I wonder who the fastest in the air would be, since you've proven to be the fastest on the ground.
I'm sure that I would lose to you, besides it's not like I would form my own hold on this gives me an idea. Said Naruto as a look of realization appeared on his face.
He closed his eyes and focused on his chakra before calling out Chikura no Tsubasa, then a pair of wings made of chakra appeared from his back.
Everyone blinked in surprise at what Naruto just did. After flapping them wings to get a feel of them, Naruto turned to Rainbow Dash, who had a look of surprise.
Can I get some flying lessons from an accomplished flyer such as yourself? Said Naruto with a grin.
Sure thing, come on, let's get to the hill and I'll show you the basics, said Rainbow Dash with excitement, and dragged him to the hill.
Why do I always get dragged around? Thought Naruto, but wasn't bothered about it much to his surprise.
Soon Rainbow Dash had Naruto learning how to use his new wings to fly, and after a few tries, he was able to take off and learned how to glide, ascend and land, although he crashed on his first attempt, making Rainbow Dash laugh at him, calling it karma. After some more training, Naruto became proficient in the ability to fly, which surprised Rainbow Dash.
Whoa, Naruto, you aren't a Pegasus, and yet you are flying like one who has been able to do so his whole life, said Rainbow Dash, who was flying beside him.
That rather impressive for someone who was reborn as a unicorn. Luna said, with everyone agreeing.
I was thinking the same thing, but it feels right. Hey Dash, I just got some ideas on aerial acrobatics, which I'm sure the Wonderbolts have never come up with, said Naruto.
Really, what are these ideas of yours? Asked Rainbow Dash with excitement.
Just follow my lead and do what I do, said Naruto, who then picked up speed and rose to the sky.
Music start.
Super Mario 64 Ost, Powerful Mario.
The red button suddenly appeared on the table.
Oh, can I press it, Mr. D-Nasty? Dinky asked.
Go ahead, little one. D-Nasty chuckled.
Inky cheered as she pressed the button and a joyful tune played.
Oh, I like this tune. Fluttershy smiled.
Yes, Trixie thinks it's a fun one.
Trixie said.
Rising to the sky, Naruto flapped his wings and tucked himself in and flipped forward several times, and then looped backwards to maintain his flight.
Rainbow Dash did the same and was able to pull it off with little error.
Naruto then tucked his wings, making him go into a free fall while doing a barrel roll, then he quickly pulled up and ascended to the sky with great speed.
Now that was cool. Derpy smiled.
Now you try it out but be careful with the free fall, said Naruto.
Sure thing Naruto, I'm sure I'll get it in the first try like the other one, said Rainbow Dash with confidence.
She tried the maneuver, but then Naruto realized that she won't be able to break out of the free fall early enough, so he quickly dove after Rainbow Dash and caught her on his back before she crashed to the ground.
Yes, it was harder than it looked. Rainbow Dash frowned.
I'm sorry about messing that move up, said Rainbow Dash sadly, but Naruto shook his head.
It's not your fault, that move was tricky, so all we need to do is practice at it until you can even do it in your sleep, said Naruto with a foxy grin, making the mare blush at his smile and the close contact with his body.
He feels quite warm to the touch, thought Rainbow Dash.
Don't say a word.
Rainbow Dash shouted, blushing, seeing everyone smirk at her.
Resuming on the practice, Naruto came up with the idea of having Rainbow Dash fly behind him and then overtake him like a slingshot, which he called drafting, which he told her is great strategy to use in a racer competition.
Then the duo began to create combination moves. One such example is the dual tornado, where they fly in circles at high speed, which creates a tornado capable of drawing in anything within its range.
But these moves, I'm sure that will be in the Wonderbolts, I'm sure they will let you join, since you can form your own wings, said Rainbow Dash happily.
Music end.
The music stopped and the button vanished, making some whine at the lost.
Aw, the song ended. Dinky pouted.
It's alright sweetie. I'm sure we'll hear more songs as the story goes.
Derpy assured.
But those were some nice moves you and Naruto did, Rainbow Dash.
Scootaloo said.
Yeah, and even I agree that the Wonderbolts would be sure to let Naruto join with the moves he pulled.
Twilight added in.
No doubt with Naruto's help I'll be a better flyer.
Rainbow Dash grinned.
Maybe, but right now we need to perfect them, anyway it's getting late, so I'll see you later, said Naruto, who decided to walk back.
After saying goodbye to each other, Rainbow Dash and Naruto headed back to their homes to rest.
Next day. With Fluttershy.
Looks like it my turn.
Fluttershy smiled.
The next morning, Naruto had arrived at Fluttershy's home carrying a picnic basket, and Owl the Blue Jay was sitting on his head as usual, who also wanted to spend the day with the both of them. Knocking on the door, he waited until it was opened by the shy mare.
Hello Naruto, stuttered Fluttershy, although she was happy to see him.
He was about to reply when he was suddenly tackled to the ground by the animals, who were happy to see he blonde stallion.
Please be careful or you might hurt him.
Looks like Naruto can get along well with animals.
Trixie commented.
Yes indeed. Rarity said.
Hello Fluttershy, I was hoping that we would go out and have a picnic,
oh, and the others can along as well, since I've packed enough for everyone, said Naruto happily.
Unable to say anything since her shyness took over, Fluttershy could only nod while the animals were ecstatic at being allowed to come along.
Later Naruto led the group to a large oak tree that grew on the top of tall hill overlooking the town.
This is one of my favorite spots as its view reminds me of the view I would get when standing at the top of the Hokage Monument back at the Hidden Leaf Village.
Wish we had something like that in Ponyville. That way we could enjoy the view as well.
Applejack pouted with the others agreeing.
Do you miss your old home? Asked Fluttershy.
Yeah, I miss my old friends, and there are times I wish that I would visit it once, said Naruto with a look of sadness, which made the shy Pegasus feel a little guilty, until she saw him smile at her, but I am happy because I have formed bonds with you, Applejack, Rainbow Dash, Pinkie Pie, Rarity, Twilight Sparkle and every pony else here. But enough reminiscing, let's have some fun.
Everyone but Derpy, Dinky, Vinyl, Octavia and Trixie smiled at the thought of Naruto liking that he formed bonds with them.
Naruto had brought along a ball to play with the animals, and soon they played a game of catch. They were able to convince Fluttershy to join in, which made her happy.
But then one of the birds had injured one of its wings, and Fluttershy had forgotten to bring her first aid kit. She was about to fly back to the house when Naruto stopped her.
Hold on shy. I should be able to heal this level of injury, said Naruto, then he channeled bit of his chakra to his front hoof over the bird's wing, healing it within a few seconds. It tweeted happily and flew to his head, making Owl glare with jealousy.
Everyone chuckled as Ao was jealous that her spot was taken, but were amazed at Naruto's healing ability. Bachan had taught me how to use my chakra to heal small injuries when I don't have a first aid kit, said Naruto. Fluttershy sighed in relief as she was worried for the bird's health.
After eating the lunch Naruto brought with him, Fluttershy saw him bring out a strange instrument which piqued her curiosity.
Naruto, what kind of instrument is that? She asked.
This is an ocarina, it's like a flute, but with more holes. I like to play music as it calms my nerves and makes me relax, and I'm good at different types of music, would you like to listen?
Naruto said, Fluttershy and the animals nodded.
Then he formed his chakra arms to hold it and began to play a tune from the ocarina.
The button appeared and Sweetie Belle pressed it this time as the tune played, putting everyone at ease cause it was so soothing as he played Fluttershy and the animals began to relax, and the winds carried the melody throughout Ponyville and any pony who heard it felt at peace. A certain light gray Pegasus who was at her home heard it as well.
Hey, that's me. Derpy smiled.
This melody makes me feel calm as if there is nothing to worry about, I wonder who is playing it. I hope to meet the pony, she thought. Meanwhile upstairs a filly looks out of a window when she heard the song as well.
I'm there too, Mom. Dinky giggled.
I feel warm and happy listening to this song, I wish Mom and I would meet this pony, I hope it's a stallion, she thought happily before going to bed, using the song as a lullaby. Elsewhere a dark gray earth pony listened to the song with interest.
What do you know?
I'm there as well.
Octavia grinned.
Whoever is playing this song is quite talented, I hope to meet this pony at an opportune time, she thought before trotting away. Back with Naruto, when he finished playing the song he looked around to see that all of the animals had fallen asleep, then he saw Fluttershy sleeping while leaning onto him, and his tail had subconsciously curled around her. It didn't take long until Fluttershy woke up and noticed how close she is with the stallion, she let out an eep before hiding behind the oak tree, trying to hide her blush. Fluttershy blushed and bowed her head in embarrassment as everyone chuckled.
Sorry about sleeping on you, Naruto said Fluttershy while peeking from behind the tree.
It's fine, Shy, I'm okay with it, said Naruto with a foxy grin. Her behavior is just like Hinata, but it doesn't bother me at all, he thought. Fluttershy smiled at the thought she was like Hinata, let's wake the others up, and I'll escort you home, Fluttershy nodded in agreement. Soon Naruto saw her off at her home before heading home.
Next day. With Rarity.
Looks like it's my turn.
Rarity smiled. Naruto had arrived at the carousel boutique to meet with Rarity, knocking on the door it was opened to reveal the white unicorn.
Hello Naruto, it's good to see you, I was just thinking of you, said Rarity smiling happily.
Hi Rare, good to see you too and please stop teasing me, said Naruto while blushing in embarrassment. Rarity giggled softly at the blonde stallion's reaction.
He is rather cute when he's blushing.
Rarity giggled.
You can say that again.
Vina laughed.
Anyway, I will need your help in making some clothes for a special event at Canterlot, and I hope to learn of your clothes from your world, said Rarity.
Sure thing Rare, I even need your help in making some clothes, plus I've got some ideas for you, said Naruto getting himself ready to help out Rarity. Later on, Naruto served as Rarity's mannequin as she used her magic to use her tools to fit the fabrics, as well as measure them, and cut to size.
So far so good, but it seems that we are low on gems, but we are close to the deadline, said Rarity with a look of worry.
That's not good. Sweetie Belle frowned.
Don't worry Rare, I know just the substitute, just wait a bit, said Naruto before galloping out of the shop, making the white unicorn wonder what he is up to.
It wasn't long when Naruto returned with his satchel which he opened to reveal the crystals.
Oh.
The crystals he found in the cave. Rarity smiled in realization and excitement. With those kinds of crystals they would make great outfits.
Leave it to Rarity to gush over crystals.
Luna giggled.
Hey, there is nothing wrong with beauty.
Trixie defended.
Where did you get such beautiful crystals, Naruto?
I've never seen them before whenever I go out gem collecting. Asked Rarity, who looked mesmerized at the sight of the crystals.
I found them in the cave I woke up from, and it seems like they are special cause when I channel either my chakra or magic they change color, so I am researching on them, but I can spare these, said Naruto with a smile.
Thank you Naruto. With these crystals, this would be one of my greatest works yet. Said Rarity, who jumped at Naruto and hugged him and nuzzled his face which rubbed his whisker marks, making him purr. D-Nasty, Spike, and Scootaloo covered their ears as everyone squealed at the cuteness of what Naruto just did. After a minute, they separated from each other, blushing bright red.
Well, let's get back to work, shall we?
Everyone oohed at Rarity, who blushed before scoffing at them and turned her head.
Yeah, let's hurry so that we can start on the ideas I have, said Naruto, shaking his head as if to clear his thoughts.
They resumed on making the clothes, then they finished and wrapped them in parcels for delivery.
Now that we are done with the requests, I needed your help in making some clothes.
Of course dear, so what are we making? Said Rarity with a twinkle in her eye. Soon the duo had made a hoodie jacket which was black and orange with a red spiral on the back, a long coat with a hood with a black collar with red flames and a kanji for purity, and a pair of goggles which he now wears around his neck.
These clothes look very good on you, makes you quite the handsome stallion.
He does look handsome in those clothes.
Rarity blushed.
Yeah.
I think Naru looks cool.
Pinkie Pie gushed.
Then that makes me the most handsome stallion alongside the most beautiful mare of Ponyville, Naruto teased playfully, making Rarity blush at the thought of it.
The real Rarity blushed while the other mares of the main six grumbled as everyone else snickered. Anyway, I'll see you around.
After leaving the boutique and on the way back to the house, Naruto thought to himself, I'll need to get back to the cave to get more of the crystals and place a seal on it to prevent trespassers from discovering it.
That's actually a good idea. Wouldn't want any pony taking my crystals. Rarity nodded in agreement.
Next day.
With Applejack.
Yeehaw.
I'm next.
Applejack cheered.
Naruto woke up early next morning to spend the day with Applejack, so he put on his new jacket, went downstairs to have breakfast with the Apple family.
Good morning everyone, said Naruto. Everyone turned and smiled at the appearance of the stallion. Ever since he moved in, it was never a dull moment with him, as he always livened things up with his personality and antics. Granny Smith often says that he could become part of the family for real by marrying Applejack, which embarrasses both ponies, making them blush red like the apples in the farm.
Granny Applejack winced as everyone laughed, but the others from the main six who were irked about the marrying comment.
Howdy Naruto, aren't you looking dandy today? You got those clothes from Rarity, right?
Cause she is the only one to do so, said Applejack, admiring the new look on the blonde stallion.
Thanks AJ, Rare and I made them together since I felt that I need a wardrobe change, since I didn't have much choice of clothes back at where I came from, said Naruto, making the mare nod in understanding, as they don't need any pony to learn of his origins.
Ready for the usual apple bucking? Said Naruto as he headed for the fields with Apple Bloom riding on his back as usual.
Sure thing Naruto, I'm right behind ya and there is something I want to ask from you, said Applejack, who was close behind.
Okay, after we finish with the chores then you can ask me what you need, said Naruto, taking position under a tree to bucket in order to knock down some apples.
After Big Mac joined in bucking the apples. The trio worked on gathering the apples and then they went to the stall to sell their daily wares, and when they were done, Applejack led Naruto to the field.
So what is it you want to ask of me, AJ? Asked Naruto with a lot of curiosity.
Well, the thing is that I was hoping that you could teach me how to fight with your fighting style, said Applejack nervously.
Everyone but the nasty blinked in surprise. Naruto looked surprised, but then asked seriously.
Why do you want me to teach you, Pinato?
It's because I want to be able to protect my family and friends from harm, because I care about them, said Applejack, while looking determined, to which Naruto smiled brightly.
Oh, thanks sis.
Apple Bloom smiled, hugging her sister, who chuckled and hugged her back, as everyone else smiled at Applejack at the thought of her wanting to protect them.
Then my answer is yes, said Naruto happily, and found himself in a bear hug by Applejack, who was happy to be taught.
Later on, Naruto was teaching the mare the basic katas of the fighting style, since he knew that she was fit to do it.
Applejack, you must remember that when facing an opponent, you must be aware of your surroundings, as anything can either help or obstruct you in the battle. You must also know when you must attack, defend, or better yet counter, as attacking an opponent deals more damage than normal. When against an enemy who uses long-range attacks, then he must be weak at close combat. A close-range opponent is helpless against long-range attacks, said Naruto. He knew how to teach, due to spending time with Konohamaru, Mogi and Yuden, when he didn't have any missions.
Sounds like Naruto's a pretty good teacher. Spike grinned.
Is there anything else I should be aware of? Asked Applejack, who was listening with rapt attention.
You must be very careful when fighting against enemies who have a lot of experience, as they will make it difficult for you to get a hit on them.
I'm sure you remember seeing that in one of my memories, said Naruto. Applejack nodded, remembering the battle he had with Kabuto.
And another thing, I want to tell you what my teacher back then told me. Those who break the rules are trash, but those who abandon their comrades are worse than trash. Let's get going before we're late for dinner, said Naruto, helping Applejack up with his tail, and the duo headed back to the house, eat and sleep because of the training.
And that became the very philosophy Naruto lives by.
Celestia smiled.
Got that right.
D-Nasty chuckled.
Next day.
With Twilight Sparkle.
S, I'm the last one.
Twilight smiled.
Naruto was at the front of the library where Twilight and Spike now reside. Knocking on the door, it was answered by the young dragon.
Hey Naruto. It's great to see you. Said Spike happily. The baby dragon had taken a liking to the blonde stallion, as Naruto often drops by when Twilight is out to keep him company, and treats him to the gems he finds from the caves during his explorations, and enjoys the stories of Naruto's pranks from his dimension.
Well, isn't that nice?
Octavia smiled at Naruto, wanting to keep Spike company.
Yo Spike, how's it going?
Is Twilight around? Said Naruto, smiling at the dragon.
Yeah, she is inside waiting you, and I can tell she is excited to learn more about you and your powers, said Spike.
Thanks Spike, oh I almost forgot, here is some of your favorite gems I found in a cave, just be sure to hide from Twilight, or she will fuss about me spoiling you too much, said Naruto, winking at Spike, who winked back before entering inside to meet with Twilight, who reading a book.
Spike Twilight frowned.
Oh come on Twilight. I can't function without my gems. Spike protested.
That reminds me, would you like another cheesecake flavored gem? D-Nasty asked.
Yes please. Spike shouted before Twilight could say otherwise.
D-Nasty snapped his fingers, and a large cream-colored gem appeared in Spike's lap, who began to eat it with gusto, making everyone laugh, while Twilight sighed at the sight.
Hi Twilight. How are things going for you? Said Naruto, smiling at Twilight, who smiled in return.
Hello Naruto, it's good to see you, things are okay with me, and I was hoping to talk to you about your powers and other things, said Twilight.
You always did want to learn new things. And considering Naruto is from a different world that just buzzes your interest.
Celestia giggled, making Twilight chuckle and embarrassment blushing.
No problem, so what is it you want to know? Said Naruto, who sat across the table ready to answer her questions.
Well, I wanted to know about this energy that you call chakra, as I've read a lot of books, but found nothing helpful, said Twilight, who had a pen and paper ready using her magic.
Well, chakra is an energy created by combining physical energy and mental energy. It enables any pony who uses it to perform feats that no normal pony can perform, and it also serves as a source of life, so should one completely exhaust his chakra, he dies, said Naruto.
That still seems pretty heavy if you run out of chakra.
Scootaloo frowned.
It's just how things are, little one. D-Nasty said.
Okay then, what can you do with chakra? Can you give me some examples? Said Twilight, writing on the paper.
I've seen ninjas from different villages use their chakra to execute techniques with the elements like shoot fire, wield lightning, control water and other things.
I used to create solid copies of myself in battle, and a certain elite ninja could perform illusions, however all of these techniques require us to use our hands to form a string of certain signs to perform, but there are some techniques that don't require hand signs.
For example, now that I am a pony I can't use clone duplication anymore, but I can use my father's technique, the Rasengan, said Naruto, forming a chakra arm to create a spiraling ball of energy which amazed Twilight.
No matter how many times I see that Rasengan, it's still awesome.
Rainbow Dash chuckled.
I know. I would I could do something like that. Pinkie Pie laughed.
I think that would be most irresponsible to you, a technique like that, Pinkie Pie. D-Nasty sweat dropped as everyone else nodded their head in agreement with Pinkie pouting at them.
You guys are no fun. She said.
No, we're just not that crazy. Everyone thought.
Thanks for telling me, Naruto, I'm sure to learn more from you later on, so is there anything that you want to know? Said Twilight, putting the pen and paper away.
Naruto thought deeply before remembering something that was at the back of his mind.
Actually, I wanted to know more about magic since it is foreign to me. I already know about the basic information and how to channel it to my horn, but I need your help on how to use it. Said Naruto.
I can teach you about levitation and other basics, but magic is capable of doing a lot of things as new magic is discovered everything, said Twilight, displaying an example by levitating a book from the top of a bookshelf.
Naruto tried it as well and was able to levitate a book from the shelf, thanks to training on his Chakura no Sosuke Jutsu, which made it easier to use his magic.
Since Twilight says that you can create your own magic, since there is no fixed element on a pony unlike back at the Elemental Nations, then I wonder if... Thought Naruto, then he asked Twilight, Twilight, can you take me to where there is a lake?
With a look of curiosity, Twilight teleported the both of them to a nearby lake.
What do you plan to do, Naruto?
He didn't answer but channeled magic to his horn, making it glow orange, and then a stream of water rose from the lake and slammed into a tree, surprising the mare.
What was that? She shouted.
Cool.
Spike, Scootaloo, Sweetie Belle, and Apple, Bloom shouted.
Well, I thought of using magic to create a stream of water and it worked. I got the idea from a certain ninja I met on a mission. I think I'll call it Water Stream, said Naruto, rubbing the back of his head.
Is it possible for me to learn it? Asked Twilight with a look of excitement, to which Naruto nodded.
Yeah, the magic is in a way that a lot of unicorns with good control of their magic can use it, and if I come up with any more, then you'll be the first to know, said Naruto.
Twilight blushed at being able to learn new magic with the blonde stallion.
Let's return, it's been a long day for the both of us.
I don't want to hear it. Twilight shouted as half of everyone smirked at her, while the other half gave her the stink eye.
Soon after leaving the library, Naruto checked out the Apple's mailbox and saw a message addressed to him from Mayor Mare. Then he went to his room and opened the letter to read, and by the time he was done reading, Naruto was smiling happily.
With this I can finally commence with my plan for a certain sumpony, he thought.
Taking off his jacket, Naruto went to bed thinking of how happy a certain pony would be.
If I may D-Nasty, could I read the next chapter? Celestia asked.
Sure.
D-Nasty said as the book was passed to her.
Now then. Celestia said. Chapter 8.
Hey, we can't read the title.
Luna frowned.
Really?
It should be. D-Nasty was interrupted when his phone began to go off and he answered it.
Hello?
Yeah, we were just about to start the chapter, but the title vanished.
Wait, you did that?
Why?
D-Nasty frowned before chuckling on what he heard.
Oh, that is gold.
Okay, I'll tell them.
Bye.
He said, hanging up his phone.
What's up?
Trixie asked.
The author thinks it would be fun to hold off the title, so what happens in this chapter for it to be a surprise?
D-Nasty grinned.
Oh, what?
Rainbow Dash frowned.
Looks like you'll just have to deal with it.
D-Nasty shrugged.
Well, alright.
Celestia said as she continued to read.
It is a sunny day in Ponyville, and every pony is going on with their regular duties, however they feel as if there is something missing, and after a minute of thinking, every pony realized that a certain blonde stallion hasn't been seen recently, as he would be seen trotting through the street greeting every pony with his cheerful personality. This has been noticed by Applejack, Pinkie Pie, Rainbow Dash, Fluttershy, Rarity and Twilight Sparkle, as they spend the most time with the blonde stallion, so they decided to meet up at to discuss this mysterious occurrence. The next day, the main six met up at the Sugarcube corner where they gathered at the table with Pinkie Pie, bringing in muffins for them to snack during the meeting. Have any of you guys noticed that Naruto has been spending less time than usual when hanging out with us? Said Twilight while thinking deeply whenever he comes to the library to study magic with me. He seems to have his mind wander and is always in a hurry to leave, saying that he has some urgent matters to attend to, and he won't reveal what they are every time I ask, which makes me suspect that he is up to something. Even Spike says that Naruto doesn't come around these days. Twilight and Spike frowned, looking at one another at that. You're right about that, Twilight, said Rainbow Dash. Whenever I challenge Naruto to a friendly competition or want to just hang around, he always refuses, saying that he doesn't have the time to waste, and he has something to do, but I don't see him doing anything for any pony in the town. Scootaloo says that Naruto has been seen carrying something in his satchel, and makes sure that nobody sees what's inside, which makes me believe that he's got something going on. The mares were surprised, as they all know that Naruto is not the kind of pony who would turn down a challenge, especially from Rainbow Dash, who both are alike in so many ways, since they both have a competitive nature. Yeah, that doesn't sound like my racing buddy. Rainbow Dash muttered. I've not been seeing Naru either, said Pinkie Pie, who was munching on a muffin. He hasn't been coming around the shop to help with the orders or to assist in planning on the parties. Whenever I find Naru and try our usual surprises, he just disappears, which is strange, as I was always able to find and surprise him without getting caught, which is different from the normal routine, so he must be planning something, maybe a secret party. The mares shook their heads to the conclusion that Pinkie Pie came up with, but were shocked that Naruto would be able to hide from the pink mare, as every pony knows that it is almost impossible to detect or hide from Pinkie Pie, who is practically a master at surprising ponies. That is true. It is impossible to hide from me. Even Rainbow Dash couldn't. So how is Naruto able to hide from my master skills? Pinkie Pie pouted. I haven't been seeing him too, said Fluttershy timidly. He hasn't been coming around to visit for a while, and all the animals misses him. They really like playing with him. The birds told me that they have been seeing Naruto going in and out of town, sometimes carrying his satchel or pulling a cart that is covered with a blanket. He came around once and told me that he would be busy and let us know when he is done. Even now the Blue Jay hasn't been with him, either. Every pony knew that all of the animals enjoys Naruto's company, which Fluttershy describes as soothing and makes them feel safe, so it must be serious for him to be visiting them. That doesn't sound right. Fluttershy said. Well, Naruto has been coming to the boutique, said Rarity with a depressed look, but only when I have a deadline to meet with the ponies who ordered some clothes to be made. But after he is done, he would immediately saying that he has some things to collect. Sweetie Belle would ask for his whereabouts, as he usually helps with her designs, as she normally messes them up. For him not to be doing what he normally does is questioning. Rarity frowned. Well, the same could be said on my side, said Applejack. Recently I've noticed that Naruto would wake up early in the morning and eat his breakfast like he is in a hurry, and would leave after he is done with the apple bucking. He even postponed my training in the Pinato, saying that he has something going on and that we could pick up on my training later. Apple Bloom often asks what he is up to, and he would always say that it is a secret and that he would reveal it in good time, as he doesn't want to spoil the surprise, but sometimes I would notice him carrying papers containing drawings which I've never seen before. Well, that can sure pique a feller's curiosity. Applejack muttered. Hearing the statements, the main six came to the conclusion that Naruto is secretly doing something that he doesn't want any pony to find out, which has something to do with his going in and out of town, the strange drawings, what he carries in his satchel, and the amount of time that he spends with them. They want to find out what he is planning, whether he likes it or not. From what we're hearing, Naruto is up to something very secretive. Octavia hummed in thought. But Trixie wonders what it is. Trixie said. You'll just have to find out. D-Nasty grinned. Well, I say that we keep an eye on Naruto and follow him to whatever secret he is hiding, as we are his friends and are concerned, said Rainbow Dash, to which the mares reluctantly agreed, seeing as they don't have any other ideas. The next 2 weeks didn't go too well for the mares, as Naruto always slips out of their radar. Whenever Pinkie tries to stalk Naruto, he would quickly disappear from her side and leave behind a note saying better luck next time. Pinkie Pie pouts at that. Rainbow wasn't having much luck either, despite being the fastest pony around, as Naruto would outmaneuver her and hide in different places, making her give up the search. Rainbow Dash muttered dang at losing him. Fluttershy would try to have the birds and animals follow his trail and scent, but it often leads to wild goose chases, as it sometimes makes them go in circles. Fluttershy wind as her animal friends were tricked. Twilight tried to talk to Naruto in order to make him slip up about what he has been up, but he was extremely tight-lipped about it and wouldn't talk about it. Twilight hung her head in shame cause she thought she was a good information getter. Applejack didn't do anything. However, Apple Bloom, Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo tried to talk to Naruto about what he has been up to, but he would always tell them that it's a secret and would always smile at Scootaloo before leaving Applejack. Puffed out her cheeks at her other self not doing anything, this continued for a while, until they finally gave up and following the blonde stallion. Why do you think Naruto would always smile at you, Scootaloo? Apple Bloom asked looking at her. Beats me. Scootaloo shrugged. One morning, Applejack woke up to some pony knocking on her door and went to open it, only to find nobody there but a letter on the floor. Opening the letter it read out, "Meet me at the town square, and I'll reveal the secret as I am well aware that you have been following me and trying to find out what I've been up since I haven't been spending much time with you, and for that I apologize. Be sure to bring along Apple Bloom, Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo, as I have a nice surprise for them as well. I would write more, but I prefer to wait until you show up to see it." Naruto. Well, that was vague. Vinyl muttered. After reading the letter, Applejack immediately left for the town square with Apple Bloom, since there was no school today. When she arrived she saw the other mares along with the fillies who just arrived as well. "I guess you all received the same letter I got." They all nodded to confirm. "Yeah," Naruto wrote on the letter that he would tell about this secret that he was able to keep from us, said Twilight with Spike riding on her back. "It's about time that we finally find out he has been hiding. It's been nagging me for a long time that I even have trouble sleeping," said Rainbow Dash, much to the agreement of the others. "I would feel the same way if I was in my other self's shoes." Rainbow Dash nodded. "I hear that." Derpy agreed. "Hey guys," said a familiar voice. The mares looked upwards to see the evasive blonde stallion descending towards them with his chakra wings. No sooner had he landed when he was tackled to the ground by Pinkie Pie with the fillies following suit. "Oh Neru, we really missed you. We haven't been seeing you much at all. Where have you been?" said Pinkie Pie, who has wrapped Naruto in a tight hug, making it difficult for him to breathe, so Twilight had to use her levitation spell to lift the overexcited mare from the barely alive stallion. "Geez, Pinkie. Cut off his air supply, why don't you?" D-Nasty teased. "Not my fault, I wanted to hang with my best buddy." Pinkie Pie pouted. Naruto rubbed the back of his head sheepishly and said, "Well, I wanted to surprise you all with what I had planned, but I didn't want you to spoil the surprise, which was why I prevented you from following me, as well as asking me questions about it. Although I'm sorry about not spending much time with you guys, what I'm about to show you will more than make up for it. So follow me and I'll show you." With that, Naruto walked out of the town square with the mares following close behind, curious about where they are going. It took a while until they arrived upon a sight which stunned them, as they've never seen anything like this before. "Welcome to my new humble abode, I call it the Uzumaki Mansion," said Naruto while dramatically showing them the new home that was built near the outskirts of town. It is a two-story building with an Eastern country design. There is a stone path to the mansion with a lawn of grass at both sides, and an apple tree on the left side. Everyone, but D-Nasty was in awe at the home. "Come on in, I'll give you a tour." As the mares toured through the new building, Naruto revealed to them that there are two bathrooms located on the two floors and several guest rooms on the second floor and a balcony, a living room, a library much to Twilight's excitement, a training room at the basement. The kitchen which had a door leading to the back of the house to reveal a small garden on the right side, and a very large oak tree, which had a wooden spiral staircase leading to a treehouse built at the top.
"Wow. That place looks amazing," Sweetie Belle exclaimed.
"I agree. The design is pleasing to the eye." Rarity smiled. "I had it built so that you girls could have your CMC meetings there or to just come and hang out," said Naruto with a smile. He was tackled to ground by the fillies who were muttering thank you repeatedly. Apple Bloom, Scootaloo, and Sweetie Belle gave a whoop at having their own hangout. There was a lake at the center with a summer hut built over it. There were also some small trees and flowers planted around. "There is one last room I need to show you, as there is some I want give you all." Naruto led them back into the mansion to a room opposite the entrance to the training room. It is a room where there are tools, materials and other items on shelves and a table at the end. "This is my work room where I make special items and examine any artifacts I might discover when I move around Equestria every once in a while."
"Wow, this place is amazing. Where did you get the money to build it?" asked Rainbow Dash.
"I went to Mayor Mare with the blueprints I made and gave her some crystals, which I'm sure you are familiar with, Rarity," said Naruto, pointing to the crystals on the table with his tail.
"Boy, those things must be worth a lot," Applejack whistled.
"Makes you wonder how much," Trixie said.
"Are those the crystals you gave to me on that day?" asked Rarity, to which Naruto confirmed by nodding.
"I'm sure you remember about how I study the art of Fuinjutsu," asked Naruto, to which the mares nodded. Well, normally you need chakra to be able to use it, but I discovered that magic can serve as an alternate option, and these crystals produce special effects when I draw a seal on them, and can recharge themselves by absorbing magic in the atmosphere, the mares, especially Twilight, were surprised at. What Naruto was telling them is this could really help a lot of ponies.
That's a genius way to use crystals, Octavia said.
You're right on that, Octavia, Vinyl said.
What are the special effects when you apply these seals on them? Asked Twilight excitedly.
Well, so far I've discovered that the crystals can produce heat or light, storage without weight, and I just discovered that it can produce a barrier to guard against physical as well as magic attacks. I have even fitted them already, so hold and let me get them. Naruto went to a closet and brought out a box and placed it on the table. He took out a bracelet with a white crystal that has a symbol drawn on it attached, and gave it to Twilight, who wore it on her hoof. All you have to do is call out protect, and it will do the rest.
Protect, said Twilight. Immediately the bracelet glowed, and a transparent dome appeared surrounding her, amazing the mares who were watching.
Wow, the main six said in awe.
Now that's awesome, Spike and Dinky said.
That could be helpful to a lot of ponies, Luna said, with Celestia nodding in agreement.
Wow, that's so cool, said Pinkie Pie, bouncing excitedly.
Naruto gave the other mares more of the bracelets and went back to the closet to bring another box.
I've got something made for you girls, specially made, said Naruto. He gave Rarity a black hairpin with flowers and a violet crystal. For Fluttershy is a hair clip in the shape of a pink butterfly and yellow crystal. For Pinky is a string of beads with a pink crystal. For Applejack and Twilight is a medallion with an orange and red crystal respectively.
These crystals have the ability to store any amount of items no matter the size. All you have to do is be near the item and call out store. And when you want to bring out an item, then call out release.
Then the name of the item. Then he gave Rainbow Dash a pair of goggles which is similar to his own, but the crystals have been formed into transparent lenses. These goggles grants you the ability to see in the dark and locate magic signatures.
Thanks a lot, Naruto, this will really help with my flying, said Rainbow Dash.
Oh, I want special made goggles, Rainbow Dash wind.
Thank you, Naru, now I can pack more of my party stuff, said Pinky, hugging the blonde stallion.
Oh, that kind of gift would come in handy, Pinkie Pie pouted.
She's right, I can always keep my books nearby when I need them, said Twilight.
I wish I had something so useful. Twilight puffed out her cheeks.
Thank you for the gift, Naruto, said Fluttershy while trying to hide her blushing face.
That's so nice of him. Fluttershy smiled.
Thank you, dear, this hairpin makes me look more beautiful, said Rarity happily.
I completely agree, my other self. Rarity smiled proudly.
I'm really happy to receive this from you, so thanks, Naruto, said Applejack.
Darn tootin' I am. Applejack grinned.
You're all welcome, and before I forget, I have one more surprise, and it's for you, Scootaloo, said Naruto, to which the said filly looked at him in surprise.
Read this, Naruto gave a piece of paper to her to read. After reading through it, Scootaloo started to cry and tackled him to the ground.
Huh? Scootaloo said, surprised at what her other self did.
Wonder what that was about? Dinky wondered.
What was it you read, Scootaloo? Asked Rainbow Dash, to which she replied happily, it is the adoption papers from the orphanage, meaning that Naruto is now my big brother.
Everyone was stunned to hear that before they remembered what Naruto said about him and Scootaloo becoming family, and cheered for her, as she was crying happily at the thought of having someone like Naruto as a big brother. Upon hearing that, the mares were shocked for a moment, and then they were happy that Scootaloo finally has a family.
After hanging around the mansion and testing out the crystals, the mares left, leaving Naruto and Scootaloo, as he had packed her belongings secretly to surprise his new sister.
Big bro? Asked Scootaloo while fidgeting.
What is it, little sis? Said Naruto curiously.
Can I sleep together with you tonight?
Oh, Scootaloo wants to sleep with her new big brother. Luna squealed.
Nothing wrong with that. She just wants to be with her new family.
D-Nasty smiled.
That's right. Scootaloo grinned happily.
Of course, I was just about to ask you the same thing, said Naruto happily. Soon they went to his room and slept.
Now I have a new home, a new family and a new life. I'm looking to what adventures I will have in the future.
Now that was lovely. Celestia smiled as the chapter ended.
Sure was. Derpy said.
Hey look. The title's appearing. Pinkie Pie exclaimed, pointing at the title, making everyone look as the words came into view.
Chapter 8. A new home and a new family, the title said, making everyone smile.
Now that's a fitting title. Vinyl said.
Makes up for not knowing earlier. Octavia said.
I'm really happy for you, Scootaloo. Sweet Bell said to Scootaloo.
Yeah. Having a brother like Naruto is awesome.
Apple Bloom nodded.
Thanks guys.
Knowing someone like Naruto going through all that to be my new big brother makes me feel happy.
Scootaloo smiles.
As it should, little one. You are never alone. whether it's your real life or life in the book, you always have people who love and care about you. D-Nasty said.
You're right.
Scootaloo said, agreeing with him.
I want to read the next one.
Luna said.
After you.
D-Nasty said, with the book being passed to her.
Right.
Luna nodded.
Chapter 9.
Meeting a ditz. For some reason Derpy couldn't help the twig of annoyance that flowed through her and stop herself from frowning, confusing everybody but D-Nasty, who held in his snickers. It is a beautiful morning at the Uzumaki mansion in Ponyville, when Naruto woke up from the rays of the sun, although slightly annoyed at waking up from a nice dream. Why did I have to wake up at the moment I leapt off the springboard and was about to splash into a giant bowl of ramen? Sometimes I hate you, son, thought Naruto, pouting at the sun. Everyone laughed or snickered at Naruto's pouting face and his dream anyway. I'd better go wake up Scootaloo for breakfast, or she will be late for school. He trotted upstairs and quietly opened the door to his sister's bedroom to her still asleep. Everyone awed at how cute Scootaloo looked sleeping, while said Philly blushed in embarrassment. He went over and nudged her awake. Scoots, wake up, you have to get ready for school, and you don't want to be late. Scootaloo woke up and rubbed her eyes before turning to her brother with a smile. Sure thing, bro, I'll take a bath before coming downstairs to have breakfast. Naruto smiled back and went downstairs to the kitchen and began to prepare breakfast, which was a plate of sandwiches, orange juice, apples and salad. Then he went ahead to prepare a lunchbox for Scootaloo to eat at school, and one for himself, as he plans to have lunch at the park after his daily run in the town. After preparing breakfast, Naruto willed his chakra arms and used them to carry the platter to the summer hut, and waited for Scootaloo, who showed up wearing a pair of goggles on her forehead and a medallion around her neck. Naruto had made some more of the items, and gave them to the fillies, excluding the goggles, which was for his sister. Scootaloo gave out a whoop at the gift she received as Sweetie Belle, and Apple Bloom beamed with happiness since she began to live with her brother. She was very happy as he would care for her and play with her and others, especially when they formed the Cutie Mark Crusaders, as they searched for their talents and activities, and he is around to guide them as well as keep them out of trouble, although he is not above playing pranks every once in a while. The Cutie Mark Crusaders all smiled at having someone like Naruto to guide them, as well as to play around with them. After a hearty breakfast, Naruto packed their lunch boxes into his satchel and went to the entrance of the mansion, where he turned to Scootaloo with a grin.
Wheels or wings? Asked Naruto.
Wings, besides I've already stored my scooter in my medallion. I plan to hang out with Apple Bloom and Sweetie Belle at her place after school, said the young filly who jumped onto Naruto's back.
Alright then, just hold on tight, Chikura no Tsubasa. Said Naruto as wings made of energy appeared, then he leapt into the air and flew.
It was a fun flight to school for Scootaloo as Naruto was performing tricks along the way before finally landing at their destination, much to her disappointment.
Alright, have a good day at school, and I'll pick you up at AJ's place later in the day. After give her the lunchbox which she sealed into her medallion, Naruto trotted off to the sugarcube corner in order to buy some snacks to add to his lunch. Can't have a picnic without muffins, otherwise it's a crime.
Wise words, Naruto. Derpy nodded in agreement as Pinky and Dinky snorted at her comment. Meanwhile, a certain mare felt happy all of a sudden. It felt like someone is appreciating the taste of muffins. I hope to meet the pony soon, she thought happily, as she waited for her daughter to come downstairs. She is a Pegasus with a coat of bluish gray with mane and tail of pale light grayish green. She has cutie mark of 2 large bubbles and 5 smaller ones surrounding them on her flank. What is most noticeable is her grayish yellow eyes, which are crossed.
Dinky, do aren't you done yet?
Hey. That's me.
Derpy smiled.
Humming, Mom.
A voice called out as a young filly came down the stairs. She is a unicorn with a coat of pale purple, a blonde mane and tail and yellow eyes.
I'm ready.
She happily approached her mother.
And there I am.
Dinky cheered.
It's my day off from mail delivery, so how about we go for a walk around before we go and get some muffins from the sugarcube corner, said the mare. With that they left their home, not knowing of the special encounter that they would have with a certain blonde stallion.
Derpy and Dinky smiled at the fact their other selves would meet Naruto. Naruto was galloping excitedly to the sugarcube corner, while greeting every pony along the way until he finally reached his location. When he entered the shop, he tackled to the ground by a pink blur, but he smiled happily knowing who it was behind the tackle.
Pionero, it's been a while since I last saw you here. Said Pinkie Pie, bouncing happily.
Always an endless bundle of energy, aren't you, Pinkie?
D-Nasty chuckled.
That's right.
Pinkie cheered.
These pinks, we only met yesterday, so hasn't exactly been a while. Anyway, I wanted to buy some muffins for lunch, said Naruto as they walked to the counter.
Humming right up, Neru.
You know I'm sure if you met my friend you would get along, as she also likes muffins, said Pinky as she packs the muffins into a paper bag.
Really?
Who is this friend of yours, as I would like to meet her, said Naruto, who received the bag and placed some bits on the counter.
Her name is Derpy Hooves. She is a Pegasus who works as a delivery mare and often hangs out with Rainbow Dash, and she absolutely loves muffins. Said Pinkie Pie.
I sure do. They are heaven's delight.
Derpy nodded.
Oh, Derpy mom.
Vinley and Dinky laughed, shaking their heads.
Alright then, one of these days, I will follow you to meet this friend of yours. See you later, Pink, said Naruto, as he waved goodbye to the pink mare before leaving the shop and going on his merry way. Along the way, he heard some pony calling his name and turned to see Rainbow Dash flying towards him.
Yo Naruto, how's it going with you and Scootaloo? Said Rainbow Dash as she landed next to the blonde stallion.
Hey Dash, everything is fine with Scoots and I'm busy keeping her and the others out of trouble as they search for their cutie marks, but it's never a dull moment with them.
Anyway, Pink's told me that you are friends with a pony by the name Derpy, said Naruto with a smile as he walked along with the tomboyish mare.
Oh, I know her very, I sometimes help out with her delivery, she is a bit clumsy and tends to crash into ponies whenever she flies, said Rainbow Dash while laughing.
Rainbow Dash, that's not nice. Fluttershy scolded.
Tell me I'm not wrong.
Rainbow grinned.
Well, it's still not nice to laugh at one's shortcoming. Rarity said.
You can't laugh at her as you also tend to crash into ponies too, with me being your favorite landing cushion, said Naruto with smirk, to which Rainbow blushed with embarrassment.
Oh. You want some ice for that burn. Spike snickered as everyone else laughed as Rainbow's own medicine was served.
Not cool. Rainbow pouted.
Well, at least my crashes are lower in number than hers. Anyway, I'll catch you later for our daily challenges, said Rainbow Dash, waving goodbye before flying to the clouds to perform her duties.
Well, I'd better take a walk around before heading to the park to relax and then pick up Scootaloo at AJ's place, said Naruto before trotting away to the neighborhood. As he was walking through the street when he felt something close to him, it was a feeling of distress.
Ever since the battle with Nightmare Moon, Naruto noticed that he had the ability to sense the emotions of ponies around, such as anger, sadness, joy and others, but he learning how to use it by meditating, but sometimes the ability triggers without warning.
Everyone but D-Nasty was odd at having such an ability. Feeling curious, Naruto went in the direction of the source of the emotion, to see if he could help the pony out. After tracing the source, Naruto came upon who was emitting the emotion, which was a young filly who was sitting on the ground crying, to which he called out.
Hello young one, why are you crying?
10 minutes earlier.
Inky was walking with her mother all the while talking about school and other things, when she met with one of her mother's friends.
Hello Rainbow Dash, how are things going for you? Said the gray mare.
I guess after my other self talked to Naruto she ran into you and Dinky, Derpy.
Rainbow Dash said, turning to her.
Guess so.
Derpy giggled.
Hey Derpy, is today your day off? Said Rainbow Dash as she landed on the ground.
Yeah, so I thought that I should spend the day with Dinky, and we are just on our way to the sugar cube corner to buy some muffins, said the newly named Derpy.
Okay then, oh I almost forgot to introduce to a friend of mine, he is a unicorn who goes by the name Naruto, and I'm sure you like him as he also likes to eat muffins just like you, said Rainbow Dash.
Really?
I hope to meet this pony soon as I've heard of a stallion from the post office that he comes around to help out with the deliveries, most of the workers say that he is one of the fastest ponies in Ponyville, said Derpy.
Well, he has to be the fastest since he is my friend and rival, he even been helping me out with my tricks, as well as teaching me some new ones, I sure that when the Wanderbolts show up, they might have the both of us join them, said Rainbow with a smile, proud of the blonde stallion.
But I thought he is unicorn, so how can he join the Wanderbolts? Asked Derpy, who was confused.
Let's just say that he is a special pony, said Rainbow Dash.
Everyone looked at one another and grinned before laughing.
Okay then, I have to get going, so I'll see you later, come on Dinky, let's say Derpy, turning to her daughter, only to see that she is gone.
Where did she go?
She was right next to me. She began calling out for her only to receive no reply.
Oh no. My baby's gone. Derpy exclaimed.
Relax, mom. It's just the story version of me. Dinky assured.
That doesn't mean I'll worry any less.
Derpy cried, hugging her daughter.
Mom.
Dinky whined, embarrassed.
Spike and Scootaloo snickered at Dinky's embarrassment.
Let's search from the sky, she can't have gone too far. Said Rainbow Dash, the two Pegasus took to the air to begin their search.
What they didn't know was that when they were talking, Dinky was distracted by a butterfly and chased after it in order to catch it, she kept following it through the town, until she lost sight of it, much to her disappointment.
Oh well, I guess I'd better get back to mom, she tried to go back the way but kept taking the wrong way, which resulted in getting more lost. She tried to look for a familiar face, but to no avail, adding more to her distress, adding hunger to her problems, made her break down and cry.
Everyone frowned at seeing Dinky cry as Dinky felt bad for her story self. Dinky kept crying until she felt a shadow over and heard a gentle voice call out to her.
Hello young one, why are you crying? Said the voice. She looked up to see a male unicorn with an orange coat and spiky blonde mane and a foxy tail, and she also noticed the whisker marks on his face, which piqued her curiosity if they are real. She didn't know this stallion, but felt that she could trust him.
Cool. Naruto found Dinky. Applejack smiled. Thank goodness. Derpy sighed in relief. Back to present time. The filly looked up to Naruto without talking, making him feel shy, so decided to draw her attention to why she was crying. My name is Naruto Uzumaki, I moved to Ponyville a couple of weeks ago, what's your name little one? Said Naruto, giving the filly a foxy grin which calmed her down and made her smile as well. My name is Dinky Doo, and it's nice to meet you Mr. Naruto, said Dinky Doo. I have heard of that name from mom's friend, this could be him, he looks nice, and those whisker marks remind me of a fox. Barely do. Luna said. No doubt a feature he got from Kurama. Twilight said. Please call me Naruto, being called Mr. makes me feel old and distant, said Naruto with a smile. Okay, well the reason I was crying is because I got lost from my mom. My mom and I were on out for a walk since it's my mom's day off when we met a friend of hers, they were talking, and I chased after a butterfly, and ended up getting lost. A growl came from her stomach, causing her to blush, and I'm hungry too, Naruto chuckled softly before coming to eye level with the filly. Well, I can help you on both cases, I can help you find your mom, and I can get some food into that stomach of yours, said Naruto with a gentle smile. Really thank you Naruto. Said Dinky happily. I can tell that you look tired, so how about you climb onto my back, and then we head to the park as I've packed lunch, and it should be enough for the both of us, said Naruto, as he crouched down for Dinky as she climbed up to his back. Wow, his back is firm and warm, it makes me feel protected, thought Dinky as she made herself comfortable. With that the duo went towards the park have a picnic. Aw. That's so sweet. Pinky cooed at the display as did everyone else. How lovely for Naruto to be helping a young one. Celestia smiled softly. It seems chivalry isn't dead. Octavia smiled. Not when it comes to Naruto. D-Nasty chuckled. Meanwhile Derpy and Rainbow Dash were still flying over the town looking for the missing filly, but to no avail, and Derpy is getting more worried. We've been all over the place and still no sign of Dinky. Maybe we should get help from Naruto, said Rainbow Dash. Why is that? Asked Derpy. He recently told me that he could sense the emotions of the ponies around him, so if we can get him to sense the emotions of Dinky, then we should be able to find her, said Rainbow Dash. Then where can we find him? Asked Derpy, already desperate look for the pony who could help find her daughter. Well, he should be at the park as it's where he likes to meditate, so let's head over there, said Rainbow Dash. Then the two mares flew over to the park. Back with the blonde stallion, he was currently enjoying his picnic with Dinky, who was happily eating a sandwich that he made. Oh, so cute. Trixie cooed, seeing Dinky's happy expression. Got that right. Vinyl smirked. Wow Naruto, all of your food tastes delicious, I'm sure that mom would like to eat your cooking, said Dinky after she had finished eating. Thank you Dinky, how about some music before we go and look for your mom? Said Naruto, bringing out his ocarina. After receiving a nod from the young filly, he began to play with his chakra arms. As Naruto played his ocarina, the song was heard throughout the town, giving everyone the feeling of calmness and serenity, which even calmed Derpy as she approached the park. As the button appeared and was pressed, everyone was soothed by the music Naruto was playing. I think I could fall in love with this song. Sweetie Belle said, swaying her head. You know, I hope we can have a recording of these songs to listen to later on. Apple Bloom smiled. That's not a bad idea. Vinyl grinned. I'll see what I can do. D-Nasty chuckled. He was the one who played that song that day, thought Dinky as she closed her eyes and listened to the sound of the music. After a bit of playing the music, Naruto stopped playing, much to her disappointment, as she wanted to listen to and told just that. When the song stopped, the button vanished, but chuckled as they didn't want the song to end too. Ahaha, I would love like to continue to play, but don't forget that we need to find your mother first, said Naruto, to which Dinky consented. They were about to start packing the food when two Pegasus landed before them, to which they were familiar with. Mom! Shouted Dinky as she ran to embrace the gray Pegasus, which Naruto assumed is her mother. Dinky, I was so worried about you. Said Derpy, then she turned to the blonde stallion. My name is Derpy Hooves, and thank you for finding my daughter. My name is Naruto Uzumaki and you're welcome, I'm sure any pony would have done the same thing in my place. I believe Dash led you here so that I could help you search her, right? Said Naruto with a foxy grin which led to both mares to blush. Everyone smirked at Rainbow Dash and Derpy, who blush in embarrassment, causing them chuckle at their expressions. Shut up. Rainbow Dash and Derpy shouted, making everyone chuckle harder. Of course, you are the pony for the job, which was why I brought her to you. Any, I'll see you guys tomorrow, said Rainbow Dash, who took off for her home. Since that's case, let me pack up, then I'll escort you to your home, said Naruto. I appreciate the gesture, said Derpy. Then the three ponies walked home with Dinky riding on his, saying that she finds it comfy. After seeing them home, Naruto turned to leave when Derpy called out to him. I would like to thank you again for what you did, and I hope to see you again. Of course, I'll invite you and Dinky to my place for lunch, she wants you to try my cooking. Anyway, I'll see you around, said Naruto, waving goodbye before trotting to Applejack's home to pick up Scootaloo. Later that night, as Derpy tucked Dinky to bed, she listened to how her daughter spent her day with a blonde stallion. It seems like you really like him.
Yeah, he's very nice and likes to joke a lot, and he was the one who played the song that day. I hope to see him again with you and Sparkler. He also gives me the feeling of having a father, which makes me want to spend more time around him, said Dinky.
Everyone smiled, loving how Dinky in the story felt like hanging with Naruto felt like having a father.
He would make a great father. The mares thought as they blushed at the thought.
That would be nice for all of us, good night, and I'll see you in the morning, said Derpy, kissing her daughter before leaving the bedroom to her own. As she lay down to sleep, her thoughts strayed to the blonde stallion and thought, he's an interesting pony, I hope to meet him again as well, then she went to sleep.
Derpy felt happy that her other self wanted to meet Naruto again and felt a little envious.
Meanwhile at the Uzumaki mansion, as Naruto was about to sleep, his thoughts also strayed to the gray mare and the filly, and thought, I hope to meet them again, as it's fun to be with Dinky, and I want to get to know Derpy a bit more, then he went to sleep as well.
And that's the end of the chapter. Luna said.
That was nice.
Octavia smiled.
Yeah, a really lovable chapter.
Fluttershy smiled.
Yeah. It was super cool how Mom and me meet someone like Naruto.
Dinky gushed.
Yes it was.
Derpy giggled.
Before she frowned and glared at D-Nasty.
But I am not a ditz.
Huh?
Everyone said in confusion.
The chapter said, meeting a ditz. And Naruto meet me and Dinky. Now Dinky isn't ditzy in any way, so I know it was talking about me.
Derpy pouted.
It did say that. Twilight muttered.
Hey, my mom is not ditzy.
Dinky exclaimed.
That's right. She can be a bit clumsy and oblivious, but Derpy's not ditzy.
Rainbow Dash said.
Hey, I don't make the chapters, I just let you read them.
D-Nasty said before pulling out a remote.
Besides, you mean to tell me these aren't ditzy moments?
D-Nasty pressed a button, and the screen showed all of Derpy's ditzy moments, kinda making it impossible for anyone to counter it or say otherwise.
I still don't like being called a ditz.
Derpy pouted.
Don't worry, Derpy.
You're still loved by all.
D-Nasty smiled.
Yeah.
Everyone said, making Derpy smiled in thanks.
And don't worry, I betcha even Naruto will love you too.
D-Nasty smirked.
Who said I would want that? Derpy shouted, blushing bright red.
Everyone laughed at that, though the mares felt a tad bit jolzy hearing that.
On a fine day in Ponyville, Naruto was running to Scootaloo's school with her riding on his back and enjoying the wind blowing in her face. Both of them had overslept and were running late, so they had to skip breakfast, but Naruto had packed an extra large lunchbox to make up for it.
So big bro, what are you planning to do today? Asked Scootaloo with curiosity. Naruto would often go around town to help any pony who would need his assistance, whether it is labor, farming, babysitting, cooking and anything else. He often jokes that they are similar to the D-rank missions he would carry out back at his dimension.
Huh. What Naruto's doing is like D-rank mission he did back in his old world.
Twilight must.
But the difference is that he doesn't mind doing them here.
Celestia said.
Well, today I have to do some deliveries for the Sugarcube Corner, the Carousel Boutique and the post office, and after that, I will be done for the day, said Naruto. Soon they had reached the school where Naruto dropped her off. I might not be able to come and pick you up after school, so I'll see you at home, so have fun and try not to get into trouble.
Okay big bro, I'll see you at home. Said Scootaloo happily before running towards her classroom. Naruto smiled happily before galloping towards the Sugarcube Corner at a calm pace.
Upon entering the sweet shop, Naruto quickly crouched to allow a pink blur to fly overhead, before using his tail to catch it, which revealed to be Pinkie Pie.
Nice try, Pinks, better luck next time, said Naruto with a foxy grin. Pinkie giggled as she was being tickled by his tail.
Ooh, I thought I could surprise you this time, Naru. Said Pinkie Pie, pretending to pout, although Naruto could see a smile appear on her face immediately after. Most of times Naruto would avoid her surprises and tickle her with his tail as a penalty, much to the amusement of the others.
Everyone chuckled at that anyway. Mrs. Cakes and I have some birthday cakes and muffins for you to deliver, so come around to the back. Then she proceeded to drag the blonde stallion to the kitchen.
Why do I always get dragged around?
Thought Naruto as he was being carried. When they reached the kitchen, Naruto saw boxes with a Sugarcube logo on them, and guessed that they are the pastries meant to be delivered.
Whoa, they are a lot. It's a good thing that I brought along my storage crystal for this, looking at the medallion hung around his neck.
I still find that to be a useful tool to have.
Rarity said.
Yeah. It would make packing things so much easier.
Trixie said.
Totally.
I mean, do you know how much party stuff I would be able to carry with that storage crystal?
Pinkie beamed.
The power of seals is practically endless.
Kind of like magic in a way.
D-Nasty said.
Here are the pastries and these are the address to where you are to deliver them, said Pinkie Pie, passing a slip of paper which contains the information to Naruto.
Okay then, said Naruto. Then he approached the box's store.
The medallion glowed brightly and the boxes transformed into orbs of light before disappearing into the medallion. Okay, Pinks, I'll be back sooner that you can say muffins with that. Naruto took off at high speed towards the locations around town. Soon afterwards he had completed the deliveries before heading back the sugarcube corner. Pinks, I'm done with the deliveries, and they were happy with the pastries and said that they would order again.
Thanks for helping us, Naru, said Pinkie Pie happily as she hugged the blonde stallion, making him blush in embarrassment. Have some muffins as a reward before you leave.
Oh, and tell Rarity I said hi, handing a bag of the snacks to Naruto, who stored it into the medallion.
Thanks for the muffins, Pinks, I have to get going as Rarity needs me to deliver some clothes for her, so I'll see you later, said Naruto, waving at the pink mare before leaving the shop in direction of the boutique. Along the way he passed by Applejack's stall and decided to stop to buy some apples, as well as say hello to the cowmare Hiya AJ. How has the stall been running?
Howdy, Naruto, things have been running smoothly, and I haven't seen you in a while, said Applejack, who was happy to see the blonde stallion.
Sorry about that, I've doing some jobs for the ponies in town, so I've been busy. Anyway, how are you coming along with the katas of the pinato? Said Naruto, who was feeling a bit guilty at not coming around the sweet apple acres to see the apples.
Still can't believe you wanted to learn Naruto's fighting style, Applejack, Rainbow Dash said.
Indeed. Considering she's such a strong mare,
Trixie said.
Sometimes people learn what they can to protect what's important to them,
D-Nasty said.
You're right about that, Celestia said as everyone else nodded in agreement.
Though I've almost mastered the forms as I've been practicing every day after doing my chores, said Applejack.
Okay then, we'll meet at the training later on, so that I can see how you have come along. Anyway, I'd like to buy some apples and get going cause I need to do some deliveries for Rarity, said Naruto.
Sure thing, here you go and tell Rarity I said hello, said Applejack, as she gave Naruto a bag of apples which was stored in his medallion, and received some bits in return.
After departing from the stall, Naruto had reached the carousel boutique and entered to see Rarity, who was currently using her magic to stitch some fabrics together on the mannequin, while looking at the sketch which she had drawn.
Hello Rare, I'm here to help out with delivering the clothes for you, and Pinkie Pie, and AJ says hi, said Naruto, approaching the mare who stopped using her magic and turned around to smile happily at the blonde stallion.
Hello dear, I was just expecting you. A couple from Canterlot had ordered for a tuxedo and a ball gown for a ball, their servant will soon arrive at the edge of town, said Rarity.
I've been meaning to ask, but what kind of place is Canterlot?
I've been hearing the name for a while now, and it has caught my attention, said Naruto.
I keep forgetting that you came from another dimension. Canterlot is the capital of Equestria, as well as where Princess Celestia and Princess Luna live. Twilight used to live there too.
It's one of the largest cities where nobles live, and there are places like high-class restaurants, a racetrack and much more. I wish to visit that place one day, said Rarity with a dreamy look in her eyes.
You always did get dazed when talking about Canterlot, Rarity.
Pinkie Pie giggled.
Well, I guess I was a big fan. Rarity chuckled sheepishly.
The word big fan was used very loosely. Emphasis on big.
Sweetie Belle smirked.
Quiet little missy.
Rarity huffed.
It sounds like a real happening place, maybe I should visit as well as say hello to the princesses. Anyway, where are the clothes? Said Naruto, who had become interested in checking out the city on of these days.
Oh sorry, I was getting sidetracked, they are in a box on the table, said Rarity, using her magic to levitate the box from the table to Naruto, who sealed it away.
Okay, I'll be back, said Naruto before heading to the outskirts of town, where he saw a pony wearing a butler's outfit and approached him.
Excuse me, I believe you are the one who was supposed to take the order.
Yes, that's right, I was sent by the master and mistress to collect the clothes, said the pony.
Not a bad butler.
Apple, Bloom said.
DCH, but wearing the butler's outfit looks uncomfortable.
Spike pouted.
Okay then, release box. Said Naruto, then an orb came out of the medallion and transformed into the box, and he gave it to the pony, who was surprised to see what had just transpired.
That is quite an artifact, where did you get it? The pony asked with curiosity.
Actually, I made it, said Naruto.
Incredible, I'm sure that the nobles would wish to acquire such tools if you were to bring them to Canterlot, said the pony.
I will consider it when I come to Canterlot. Anyway, thanks for ordering from the carousel boutique, and I hope to see you again, said Naruto, after taking the bits and waving goodbye to the pony, before heading back to the boutique. Rarity, I've delivered the package, so I guess I'll see you later then, tell Sweetie Belle I said hi.
Okay dear, I hope to see you again soon, said Rarity.
After leaving the shop, Naruto headed to the post office, and had arrived just to see Derpy, who was about to leave on her delivery.
Hello Derpy, it's good to see you again, and how is Dinky?
Said Naruto, waving hello to the Pegasus.
Hello Naruto, it's nice to see you too. Dinky has been wanting to see you again, saying that she had fun the last time she was with you, said Derpy, smiling at the blonde stallion.
Then be sure to tell her that I'll come over and play with her when I'm less busy, as I have a little gift for her, said Naruto with a foxy grin which caused Derpy to blush.
Wow, his smile makes me feel happy and gives me a warm feeling inside, thought Derpy. I'll be sure to tell her, and I wanted to introduce you to the rest of my family.
Naruto left a pretty good impression on my other self.
Dinky smiled.
You're right, Dinky. You can't find that many kind stallions that would help a filly out of the goodness of their hearts.
Derpy smiled.
Plus it helps that Naruto has a warm smile. Not to mention the blush that was just on Derpy's face. Luna teased, making Derpy blush in embarrassment.
Something you want to say? Twilight grinned.
HMPH. Derpy pouted, turning his head, making everyone chuckle.
Okay, I hope to see you later then, said Naruto, waving at the gray Pegasus who flew off before entering the office to meet the pony in charge.
Hello chief, I'm here for the deliveries.
The pony whom he called chief turned around and smiled at the sight of the blonde.
Ah, it's you kiddo, it's great to see you around here, we really appreciate your helping us with the delivering of the letters and packages, as we keep on getting swamped with paperwork, said the chief.
It's no trouble at, I'm just happy to help out, said Naruto with a smile. I wonder if Bachan would ever figure out to use shadow clones for her paperwork.
Elsewhere in another dimension, a woman who was sitting at with tons of paperwork in front of her sneezed, causing the papers to scatter. Damn it seems like someone was talking about me and knew the answer to defeating this paperwork, but is out of my grasp. How I wish to get a hold of that person and demand him to tell me, she said before resuming to signing the paper.
Using clones to finish paperwork? Now that would be very useful.
Celestia pouted.
Sometimes I get so stressed out with all the paperwork I get.
Paperwork is the bane of all existences. People able to clone yourself to help you would be a stress reliever.
D-Nasty nodded in agreement.
Preach.
Luna sighed deeply.
Back with our pony ninja, the chief was laughing. Geez kid, you are too modest. Anyway, we have put up a bulletin board for where ponies can put up requests for help which any pony can take on, and I'm pretty sure that you would be interested.
Thanks for telling me chief, I'll be sure to check it out later. Is there anything that I need to deliver? Said Naruto.
Actually, we have some instruments that need to be delivered to a music shop on this address. I'm sure that you can handle it. Aside from that, there is nothing else, said the chief.
Okay, I'm on it, said Naruto. Then he went to the storeroom where he found the instruments, which were a cello, violin, and a sound mixer, among other equipment.
Well, I've been thinking of getting a new instrument myself, as I've been getting a few ideas for new songs. Then he sealed them away and headed for the address, where he found a shop that had several instruments on display.
He knocked on the door and heard a voice on the other side.
Hold on for just a sec, said a feminine voice. The door opened to reveal Mare from behind the door. She is a unicorn with a yellowish white coat and a mane and tail of cobalt blue with cyan stripes. She has a cutie mark of a music note which is mirrored on her flank. What Naruto noticed most was her sunglasses, which was gradient from purple to heliotrope.
Hello, and who might you be?
Hey, that's me.
Vinyl grinned.
I wonder how my interaction with Naruto will be like.
Who knows?
Fluttershy said. My name is Naruto Uzumaki, and I am here to deliver the instrument, said Naruto. The mayor, however, looked skeptical.
Are you sure?
Cause I don't see any instruments around, said the mayor.
That's because I placed them in this medallion around my neck. Show me where you want then, and I'll show you, said Naruto. Then he followed the unicorn to a large room where there were large speakers among other sound systems.
This is the place, so why don't you show me? Said the mayor.
Sure, release instruments, called out Naruto. Several orbs came out of the medallion and transformed into the said items, much to the surprise of the unicorn.
Whoa, that's amazing, I've never seen magic like that. Where did you get it? Said the mayor.
I made it by myself, and it allows me to store large amounts of items for easy transporting, said Naruto with a smile.
Naruto seems to be surprising everyone with his medallions.
Celestia giggled.
That's pretty cool, I forgot to introduce myself. My name is Vinyl Scratch and I'm a DJ, but most ponies call me DJ Pawn 3.
That's a cool nickname, and it's nice to meet you, said Naruto with a foxy grin.
I'll go get my roommate to check the instruments, in the meantime you can take a look around, said Vinyl as she walked into the next room.
Naruto walked around a bit, taking in the view of the room until he came across a clipboard which contained a score and observed it closely. That was when Vinyl came back. My friend isn't around at the moment, but I'm sure that she'll be back soon. Then she saw Naruto looking at the score. I see that has caught your interest.
I've been trying to get some lyrics for the beat, but can't seem to find the right one to fit with a guitar.
Why don't let me give it a try? I'm a bit of a music lover, so maybe I can whip something up, said Naruto as he picked up a guitar close to him.
I can't wait to hear this.
Vinyl grinned, shaking in excitement.
Okay then, let's play the song and see what you can do, said Vinyl. She placed the disc into the slot and hit the play button. Then the music started to play through the speakers. As Naruto listened, he began to get some ideas and started to sing.
The button appeared, and Vinyl was quick to press it.
One ok rock the beginning.
thus give me a reason to keep my heart beating. Don't worry, it's safe right here in my arms. As the world falls apart around us, all we can do is hold on, hold on. Take my hand and bring me back. I risk everything if it's for you. I whisper into the night, telling me it's not my time and don't give up. I've never stood up before this time. Emu yuzurinai mano nijita kono ti wahinasanai. So stand up, just gotta keep on running. Wake up, just tell me how I can. Never give up. Guruashi hodo satsuna no enrei. Just tell me why, baby. They might call me crazy for saying I'd fight until there is no more. Irei wo fukunda senkaganku wa kankakuteki shaudu. Blinded, I can't see the end. So where do I begin? Say another word, I can't hear you. The silence between us. The nimo nai yunai atsuteru dake. I take this chance that I make you mine. Ada kakusanai mano kizata yauni misakakateru. So stand up, just gotta keep on running. Wake up, just tell me how I can. Never give up. Anashimi to setsunasa no enrei. Thus give me a reason to keep my heart beating. Don't worry, it's safe right here in my arms. Kudakit nate se chita kono amoi wa. So blinded I can't see the end. Look how far we made it. The pain, I can't escape it. Tono mamaju madao eriseru kodo wa dekanai desho. Nando kudaberisu demo kuchi hadayu tomo arewanesa. So where do I begin? Nijirishimeta ishinawenu yauni tu. Ti wo hirajiriba kabori achisuta. Ushinau mano nado nakata hibino de se wo suti kimi wo. Thus tell me why, baby. They might call me crazy for saying I'd fight until there is no more. Irei wo fukunda senkaganku wa kankakuteki shaudu. Blinded, I can't see the end. Look how far we made it. The pain, I can't escape it. Tono mamaju madao eriseru kodo wa dekanai desho. Nando kudaberisu demo kuchi hadayu tomo arewanesa. It finally begins. Dot. Song end. As the button vanished, everyone was speechless of Naruto's singing. Holy vinyl muttered. Whoa. Dot. Octavia breathed. Yeah. Everyone else but the nasty agreed, who chuckled. When the music had ended, Vinyl's jaw dropped at what she had just witnessed. That was incredible. How were you able to come up with those? She was very close to the stallion, which made him a bit uncomfortable. I don't know how, just that when the song started to play, the words just came up in my mind, and I started to sing it. How was it? Said Naruto. It was great. Both the song and the lyrics were in perfect sync and blended very well with each other, said Vinyl happily. You and I definitely have to get together to make more songs. Said Vinyl with excitement. Sure, I'm down with that. Said Naruto with a foxy grin, causing the unicorn to blush behind her glasses. A stallion after my own heart. Vinyl sighed dreamily, making those that were starting to like Naruto glare at her. Trixie thinks Vinley is smitten. Trixie snickered. It would seem so. Octavia muttered, not wanting to admit she was jealous. What other instruments can you play? Asked Vinyl. Well, I can play the ocarina, said Naruto, unsealing the said instrument. At that moment, the two ponies heard a voice from behind. What is going on here? I could hear the music all the way from outside the shop, said a feminine voice. Naruto turned to see a mare, and she is an earth pony with a coat of goldish gray and a mane of dark gray. She also wears a pink bow tie with a white collar and a purple treble clef for her cutie mark. Oh, there I am. Octavia smiled, pleased. Hey there, Tavi, I've been looking for you. Said Vinyl, waving at the mare. Well, if you must know, I had gone to the post office to check for the instruments, but I was told that it had already been delivered here, and who might be this gentlicle be? Said the mare. Naruto approached the mare to greet her. My name is Naruto Uzumaki, it's nice to meet you, said Naruto with a smile. My name is Octavia and it is a pleasure to meet you. May I ask what is going on here? Said Octavia. Naruto was helping me out with the song that I made, and it was perfect. Then he was about to play a song from that ocarina of his, said Vinyl, pointing at the instrument which was held by Naruto. Well, I hope that you wouldn't mind if I listen to you play as well. Asked Octavia. Of course I don't mind, said Naruto with a smile. Then he began to play the song from when he had the picnic with Fluttershy, which surprised the mare. The button appeared as everyone listened to the soothing music. I'll never tire of hearing this. Luna sighed happily. Indeed, sister. Celestia agreed. So he was the one playing the song that day. Octavia thought as she looked at Naruto as he continued playing. Like that day, they felt the peace and serenity which was radiating from the blonde stallion, until he finished playing. That was quite impressive, Mr. Naruto, I would like to exchange some ideas with you. Please call me Naruto, I'm not one for formalities as it makes me feel kind of distant when I'm talking to some pony, said Naruto with a smile, to which Octavia smiled as well. What about me, Naruto? Asked Vinyl, who was getting a bit jealous at seeing her roommate take interest in the stallion. Vinley blushed in embarrassment, and it increased with Octavia smirked at her, making her stick her tongue out at her friend.
I would also exchange ideas with you as I like all kinds of music, said Naruto smiling at the unicorn, so as to reassure her, which worked as she had calmed down. I have to get going as it's getting late.
Okay then, be sure to visit again as we had enjoyed your company, said Octavia, seeing the stallion off.
Yeah, and if there is a party, I gonna invite you, and together we'll rock the house. Said Vinyl, raising her shades to reveal magenta-colored eyes to wink at him, which led to him blushing.
She really has pretty eyes, thought Naruto. Everyone oohed at Vinly, making her blush before she pouted at them for teasing her, sure thing.
By then, with it he walked away in direction of his home, although along the way he remembered that he had forgotten to get a new instrument for himself.
Oh well, I guess that adds more of a reason for me to come back with that thought in mind.
Naruto galloped home.
And that's it. Vinly said, smiling.
So how did you all like that chapter?
D-Nasty asked.
Pretty cool. Spike smiled.
Heck yeah. Scootaloo cheered.
Then you like the next one.
D-Nasty chuckled.
So this part ends here.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video, so quickly like this video for second part of this series.
And comment down below your thoughts about this series.
And now it's time for me to go, bye.